Australia, an island continent with a population of almost 20 million. A country with boundless beaches and vibrant waters. A country where almost 95% of its populace lives within 10 miles of the ocean. A nation whose identity is defined by water and the sea. Australia is one of four nations that has competed in every Olympics. And here in Sydney, there is great hope that the first gold medal of these games will be won by an Australian woman in the first triathlon in Olympic history. The triathlon, a combination of three disciplines, starting with a 1,500-meter swim, followed by a 40-kilometer bike ride, and climaxed by a 10-kilometer run. After almost 2 hours, the race is narrowed down to two women, Brigitte McMahon of Switzerland and Michaela Jones of Australia, ranked number one in the world. With a few hundred meters left in the race, Brigitte McMahon leads, but the cheering crowds, led by Jones's mother, believe that Jones's finishing kick will give Australia the victory. But it is not to be. Brigitte McMahon holds on to win, and Jones must settle for the silver medal. 7 hours later, in the evening of September 16th, the largest crowd ever to witness an Olympic swimming event packs the Sydney International Aquatic Center. Leading to Sydney, Australian athletes had won 88 gold medals overall, 40 of them won by their legendary swimmers. The eight finalists in the men's 400-meter freestyle walk onto the pool deck. Now all of Australia awaits the performance of a teenager already called by many the greatest swimmer in history. There is a great roar from the 18,000 spectators as 17-year-old Ian Thorpe is introduced. Thorpe is the world record holder, and at this early age has already become one of the most revered athletes in all of Australian sport, acclaimed for his brilliance in competition and beloved for his grace and humility both in victory and defeat.
Everyone said there was a lot of pressure on me to win. I don't look at it as pressure. If you turn those expectations into a negative, it becomes pressure. If you turn those expectations into a positive, it becomes support.
With each lap, Thorpe increases his lead. With less than 40 meters left in the race, the only question is whether he will break his own world record.
Swim in the last 50 and know that when I touched the wall that I was going to be Olympic champion. Just an amazing feeling to know that.
Ian Thorpe has broken his own world record by 74 hundredths of a second, defeating Massimiliano Rosolino of Italy by almost 3 seconds and Cleek Keller of the United States by almost 6.5 seconds. Thorpe will have little time to celebrate. In 1 hour, he will swim the anchor leg on Australia's 4x100-meter freestyle relay team.
Recovery time was limited. I had a medal presentation as well. I mean, it's all fantastic, but, I mean, I had another race as well. And so at the same time, I was able to enjoy that for a brief moment and then know that I had to get ready to compete in my next race.
It is 8:15 p.m. Eight teams walk onto the pool deck for the start of the 4x100-meter freestyle relay. The team consists of four men, each swimming 100 meters. Just before the Australian foursome is introduced, it is apparent that one of their swimmers is missing, Ian Thorpe.
I got changed out of my suit and I had to go and put another suit on, and I ripped it because I was trying to rush. And so I then had to put on another one. I had about three people trying to put on a wetsuit, which I don't think's been done before. When everyone walked out, there was only three Australians. And then I came running in at the very last moment, just before we were announced. And, you know, we all went up as a team and we were all ready to race.
The United States foursome, led by Gary Hall Jr., is the favorite to win. The Americans have never lost a 4x100 freestyle relay. Seven victories since the event was introduced 36 years earlier at the 1964 Tokyo Olympics. This is 25-year-old Gary Hall Jr. He will swim the anchor leg against Ian Thorpe. 4 years ago in Atlanta, he anchored both the freestyle and medley relay teams to victory and won two silver medals in the 50 and 100-meter freestyle. 17 months before the Sydney Games, Paul collapsed from what he thought was fatigue. His vision became blurred, and he shook uncontrollably. His doctor gave him the results of his physical.
It was devastating to hear you have diabetes. It was even more devastating to hear this is the end of your swimming career.
Doctors advised him to retire, telling Gary that swimming competitively would endanger his health.
You know, swimming was everything to me. It's in my nature to want to defy anybody who says, this can't be done, you can't do this. I saw these doctors saying, no, you can't do this, as a challenge and try to prove them wrong.
Gary Hall took up the challenge, but he must take daily insulin injections and test his blood sugar several times a day. 5 months after being diagnosed, he was swimming faster than he had in Atlanta when he won 2 gold and 2 silver medals. But for the courageous and outspoken Gary Hall, his arrival in Sydney was controversial over a statement which made newspaper headlines.
The one quote that was taken out of that entire article was, we're going to smash him like a guitar. If you look at the article in which that statement was taken from, it was a very favorable article to Australia. It was complimenting Australian swimming, Australian people, and saying that we have a lot to learn from what the Australians are doing. And I still believe that.
Take your marks.
Michael Klim leads off for the Australians. He is opposed by Anthony Irvin of the United States. Klim immediately goes into the lead. Making the turn at the halfway point, he is swimming the finest race of his career. He's on world record pace. Michael Klim creates a world record for the 100 meters, swimming the distance 0.03 seconds faster than the former mark held by the legendary Russian Alexander Popov.
Michael Klim led off, and he broke the world record in the first leg, and it set the tone. I mean, it set the tone for what was going to be an amazing race.
Chris Feidler is swimming the second leg for Australia, Neil Walker for the United States. As they reach the end of their swim, Walker has cut down the Australian lead. The third leg gets underway with Ashley Callis swimming for Australia against Jason Lezak of the United States. It now becomes clear that the race for the gold medal will be fought between Ian Thorpe of Australia and Gary Hall of the United States.
I was standing up on the blocks and everyone was yelling Thorpe, and it became the biggest distraction. I mean, you're trying to judge when someone touches the wall so you can go, and you're talking about hundredths of a second, the difference between a good changeover and a poor one.
I've told people that my family was so easy to spot because they were the only ones cheering for me in that 18,000 capacity crowd.
Callis of Australia is slightly ahead of America's Lezak. Ian Thorpe will have a small lead over Gary Hall at the start of the final leg. Ian Thorpe hits the water a quarter of a second ahead of Gary Hall. As he did 4 years earlier in Atlanta, Gary Hall immediately goes after the leader. The 100 meters is Hall's favorite event. Ian Thorpe prefers the 200 and 400 meters.
Around they go for the final 50. Paul is in front. What can the champ muster? A gold medalist earlier tonight. Now he's digging deep. The crowd is roaring. Their hero is coming on. Will it be a fairy tale? Thorpe is coming out up the hall. They're matching strokes now. Thorpe on terms with Hall. They've got about 15 meters to swim. Thorpe is over Hall again. Hall and Thorpe. Thorpe's in front. Thorpe and Hall. Thorpe goes in. Australia win. New world record! The Australians have just broken the American stranglehold on this race.
We didn't know what we'd done. It was quite amazing because the Americans have never been beaten in that race in the history of the Olympic Games. It was just so amazing.
Gary Hall is gracious in defeat. Though his 100-meter split time was 0.06 seconds faster than Ian Thorpe's, it was not enough for an American victory. He congratulates the Australians.
it was a great race, and that's what the Olympics is all about. You don't want to be remembered as the guys that blew the relay. But I don't think we blew it at all. You know, our effort was something to be proud of. The United States team was, you know, close to a second and a half underneath the existing world record. But we weren't the fastest people in the pool that night.
And so on this night, two men competed with valor for their nations and for themselves. Gary Hall, who overcame adversity to reach the starting line. And Ian Thorpe, who began his journey toward Olympic greatness.